Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the singing of our national anthem, sung by Devin Balaguer, music and vocal performance major from Gilbertsville, Pennsylvania.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
You may be seated. Good morning. Hi. I'm Bob Jones, and I have the privilege of serving as the Dean of the Eberly College of Arts and Sciences. On behalf of the college, it's my pleasure to welcome you today as we celebrate the achievements of our graduate degree candidates. Let's take a moment now to congratulate them on their accomplishments. Those in attendance today are some of more than 493 individuals who have earned graduate degrees from the Eberly College this academic year. Now, we know their accomplishments reflect the dedication and support of many others, some of whom are here today. We should recognize the faculty members who have worked closely with these candidates, mentoring them as junior colleagues within their disciplines. With those faculty members in attendance, please stand for a moment to be recognized. We also know that there are many others in our graduates' lives whose support and encouragement have enabled them in pursuing their academic aspirations. I ask that those parents, siblings, spouses, and friends of the candidates please stand for a moment of recognition as well. With us today are several members of the university's senior leadership. I would ask that they please stand as their names are called and remain standing. And audience, please hold your applause until all are recognized. Michelle Wheatley, Provost of West Virginia University. Catherine Carricker, Associate Provost for Graduate Education. David Friesen, Vice President for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Lisa DeBartolomeo, Faculty Senate Chair and the Armand and Mary Singer Professor in the Department of World Languages, Literatures, and Linguistics. Thank you. We would also like to acknowledge and thank graduates who have served this nation in the military with valor and sacrifice. The red, white, and blue cords these students wear today are a tribute to their selfless service. We also honor faculty, staff, and those of you in the audience who have served. Let's thank them all for the dedication and commitment they and their families have given to the United States. Graduates, commencement. As the very word implies, it's a time to look forward to all that you will accomplish as future scholars, leaders, innovators, and creators. It marks a transition point in your life, a transition from learning and preparing for a future to leading and making that future a reality. Now, what will that future look like? To reflect on that question, let's take a look back for a moment. During your undergraduate experiences, each of you focused on building analytical and communication skills. You became aware that there are many ways to define questions and solve problems or create new approaches. But you had little time to practice what you had learned. You had a large number of subjects to study, and so many of them were more introductory courses. It was graduate school where you put your training and learning to the test. You used seminars, research projects, high-level coursework, internships with high levels of responsibility, and other experiences to do things like ask and answer your own questions, or envision and realize your own creative work. So, how does all this play into your future? Like it or not, you are now going to be perceived as leaders. People will look to you to provide critical advice, to make big decisions, to plan and implement key strategies. They'll look to you to be perceptive, to be models of good citizenship, and to be scholars. People will want you to help them make their lives better. That's what's in store for you in your future. And it sounds like a tall order to fill, but you know what? You can do it. We have seen your transformation here at West Virginia. Ask any faculty member, they will tell you that you have made great progress in your capacity to think and lead. You have literally gone from knowing what can be done to knowing that you can do it. So since you are now leaders whom we all look up to and rely on, I urge you to be confident. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Learn from them. Remain confident. And remember, the door of opportunity has not been opened for you. Rather, you have invented your own door, and now you're about to walk through it to an exciting future. We are exceedingly proud of your accomplishments and feel honored that you are part of the Mountaineer family. It's now my pleasure to introduce today's commencement speaker, Dr. Earl Scime, the Oleg Jefimenko Professor of Physics and Astronomy. Dr. Scime joined the WVU faculty in 1995 and served 11 years as chair of the Department of Physics and Astronomy. And this past year, he has assumed a new role as Associate Vice President of Research at West Virginia University. Dr. Scime is an active researcher and teacher in plasma physics with 30 years of academic and consulting experience. He is a fellow in the American Physical Society and has received more than 20 other significant university and national awards for his significant accomplishments in research, teaching, and youth education. Dr. Scime, I welcome you and invite you to say a few words to our graduate students.
Thank you for those kind words, Dee Jones. It is truly an honor to be asked to share with you some thoughts about graduation today. And let me begin by congratulating each and every one of you on your achievements today. Except for kindergarten, there aren't many moments in your life when a whole room full of people make a big deal about something you've accomplished, so I really hope you'll enjoy today. Speaking of enjoying graduation ceremonies, I have to admit that after serving 11 years as department chair, one of the perks I thought of my new role at WVU would be that I wouldn't have to come to graduation every semester. But someone obviously ratted me out to the dean, and he made sure I was going to come here. But in fact, I would have come to this graduation in any case, because this morning I have the tremendous honor of hooding two of my PhD students, and that's a big moment in a faculty member's life, and so I can keep making him feel a little guilty about roping me into this, but I was going to be here anyway. Perhaps more importantly for you and your families is that last weekend I sat through my son's 5.5 hour long undergraduate graduation. And since I've decided 5.5 hours is way too long, I'm going to limit my speech to just 3 hours. And then I'll put the rest on YouTube and you can figure it out. Okay. So as I watched my son graduate and move on to his next phase of life, which is right where you're at, which is graduate school, I was certainly thinking about this speech. I've listened, I think, I tried to add it up to about 35 graduations in the past few years. And you would think that after listening to 35 graduation speakers, I would have some clever words of wisdom, some pithy insights about life, or something truly inspiring to share. So I hit the internet when I was preparing my speech. I looked for greatest graduation speeches and funniest graduation jokes. I enjoyed the jokes, and I was impressed by the clever quotes from many famous people. But none of the speeches really helped me solve my problem. What to say to you this morning? Through all the graduation events, I've heard speakers extol students to become leaders, to follow their passions, to seek out answers to the truly great questions of our time, to save the planet from global climate change, to cure cancer, or to address the issues of war, violence, and racism. Some speakers encourage graduates to inspire others, to take risks, to not fear failure, and to live a selfless life, to not waste their talents, or to become leaders of our nation. The reality is, all those speakers are correct. You have been blessed with keen minds, a great education from an outstanding institution, and I believe we all have a responsibility to live up to the investment our society has made in educating and training us. Fear of risk will hold you back, and all of you have potential for greatness. But as I pondered which of these great themes I should try and communicate to you, or which obligatory Churchill or Mother Teresa quotes to use in my speech, I was struck by how all those themes should be true for every person on our planet, not just WVU graduates on a May morning here in 2014. So what can I say to you that might really make a difference for WVU graduates this morning? What practical advice might I give newly minted MS, MFA, and PhD graduates that would help you fulfill all the exhortations of all the graduation speakers throughout the ages? So I did what all good professors do. I tried pitching a few ideas to my grad students. After they got after being horrified by my initial suggestions, they suggested practical topics, like how to swap out the water pump on a pickup truck, or how to solve really unstable differential equations in MATLAB, or how to bake a really nice apple pie. As much fun as those ideas sound, I'm not sharing my apple pie recipe with anyone. Then as I drove back from my son's graduation last weekend, and it was a 16-hour drive, so I had a very long time to think of speeches, I thought about what best advice had been given to me in my career. What advice had I been given early in my career? You know, like when years later you realize your parents, your mother and father weren't complete adults, and actually you should have listened to them that one time they told you that one thing that in hindsight now seems like brilliance. It might surprise you, but the best career advice I ever received was very simple. It was very pragmatic and not particularly eloquent. It was from a physicist, after all. The short version is, own your choices. What do I mean by own your choices? And why is this concept that I think that it's something that you as graduates might need as you get ready for this next step in your professional and personal lives? You will all be faced with seemingly trivial and sometimes life-altering choices, and sometimes it's hard to tell the difference. You've already know this to be true. In graduate school, your path was inextricably altered by whom you decided to pick as a research advisor, what papers you read, what courses you took, what meetings you went to, or maybe even a random speaker in your research field. And those have defined what you've gone on to do as graduate students. Moving forward, your career will be a succession of these choices. And it is important to realize that each bifurcation in your path will set you on a completely new path. So each time you come to one of these choices, remember why you're on that path in the first place. What are your goals? What are your ambitions? What are you willing to give up or risk to accomplish those goals? Sometimes we end up in a career or a position that we would have never thought possible. Owning your choices, for me, means that when you look back on your career and you see these bifurcations, you know why you went the way you did and that it was a conscious choice. You graduates in the audience who desire an academic career might look at my resume and wonder, how did I get so lucky? How did I make such perfect choices to end up where I am today? The truth is, I never once as a young man expected to get here. In fact, had you told me then that when I was in my 40s, I would hold an endowed chair in physics and also be the associate vice president of a major research university, I would have wondered what I did so wrong that I would have ended up as such an abject failure. Because when I was 8 or 9, my plan was to become a physicist and an astronaut. Yes, I was a strange 8 or 9-year-old. To solve the thermonuclear fusion problem, build an awesome spaceship, and be the first man to set foot on Mars. College professor was never on my game plan. Clearly, I've only achieved one of my life goals. But I know why I haven't, because as I look back on my career, I see lots of those branching points. Some I couldn't control, like getting too tall to be a military pilot and therefore be an astronaut, and some I could control, like what postdoc job to take after graduate school, or switching fields of research 3 times in my career. Let me give you a personal example. When I was a young postdoc at Los Alamos National Laboratory, I worked hard, showed real ability, got noticed by my bosses, had opportunities for lots of choices, and was offered a chance to lead a big new project at the lab. I would have had a secure career, rapid advancement, and excellent income. The only downside was that I would have to lead the development of an entirely new class of offensive weapon systems. I'd gone to Los Alamos to do space physics and nuclear test ban treaty verification, but there I was with one of those life-changing choices. So I left the lab, and I took a much less secure position at WVU at 50% the pay. If I had stayed at the lab, I might have gone back onto the path of being an astronaut. I certainly would have had a better financial position, and my career might have advanced faster. Looking back, I could resent having to make that choice, or I could own my choice and accept that I came to WVU because I chose to contribute to the lives of people in an entire state in a meaningful way. Just last Friday, I was driving back from DC with another colleague who was telling me about a professor at a nearby school who has started up a number of successful companies, has research labs in 2 countries, has a fleet of his own aircraft, and just got bought out by Facebook. And I thought, wow, that sounds really successful. I was thinking about this speech and thinking about choices. Then just as the conversation was ending up, my colleague said, and he never teaches a class, and he has a wife and 2 kids who he never sees. And I thought, own your choices. That's what it's all about. What choices do you make? Here at WVU, I have chosen to help build a world-class physics department. I have chosen to move to a place where I could raise a family in a good place with good people. I have chosen my life to be the way it is, and I am reminded once again that I own that choice. It is through that choice, and a million more to come, that I hope to achieve for me what is a meaningful life. So what does this have to do with you today? My charge to you as graduates is to own your choices. Whether it is to pass on a lucrative job for a lower paying one because the lower paying job is the one that you really want to do, or whether it is to spend the next year writing that great American novel while making ends meet with any job you can find. Remember why you wanted to go to graduate school in the first place. Do you want to inspire the next generation and teach? Do you want a shot at curing cancer? Do you want to run for a shelter for battered women and really make a difference in their lives? Or do you want to become a business mogul and amass great wealth? No matter what your ambition, look for these opportunities, look for these branching points. Get ready for them, anticipate them. Put yourself in the place of having those choices by doing the best you possibly can in your career. And then if you remember anything from this, my 36th, I count, and hopefully shortest graduation ceremony, remember to seek those choices in your career and then own them. I challenge you to live a life so that when 20 years from now, you look back at your career and wonder how you got where you are in your life, you will look back and say, those were my choices. I intentionally prepared myself to seize opportunities when they arose. I made my choice and I moved forward. So in closing, I want to congratulate you and your families once again on completing your graduate degree. Going to graduate school and then slogging your way through the required courses and research required some serious choices. You now have all the skills and training you need to achieve your life ambitions, and I wish you a meaningful career and life filled with great choices. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Scime. That was inspirational. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, please welcome Devin Belaguer, who will sing My Home Among the Hills, which was composed in 1963 in honor of West Virginia University's centennial celebration by Clarksburg native Mr. E.W. James.
There's a land of
It's almost time. Are you ready? All right. I will now turn to our department chairs for the presentation of degree candidates. We will recognize graduates in alphabetic order by department, beginning with biology. I invite Provost Wheatley to join me for the presentation of degree candidates.
Good morning, I am Dr. Rita Rio. I'm an associate professor of biology and associate chair for graduate studies in the Department of Biology. First, I'd like to recognize all the wonderful moms out there and wish you a very happy Mother's Day. So it is my pleasure to introduce candidates for the Ph.D. in biology. Dr. Zachariah Kelly Fowler, his dissertation is entitled The Effects of Accelerated Soil Acidification on a Grading Temperate Deciduous Forest, the Freneau Experimental Forest Long-Term Soil Productivity Study at 13 years. And he's being hooded by Dr. William Peter John. Dr. Ann Elizabeth Perez, her dissertation was entitled The Development of an Insect Succession Model Suitable for Time Since Death Statistics, and she's being hooded by Dr. Rita Rio.
It's my honor to present the graduate student from the chemistry department. First one, Dr. Matthew Marshall Cummings. His thesis title, A Base Module Synthesis of Indoles and Quinones, an Expanded Synthesis of Natural Product, hooded by me. Now I'm presenting you Dr. Holly Nicole Curry. Her thesis title, Analysis and Interpretation of Complex Biological Signal Transplant Networks, is hooded by Dr. Jonathan Boy. Now I present you Dr. Robert Eugene Dumbler II. His thesis title is Structural Elucidation of Glycopyrrolate Using Metallostable Atom Achieved Dissociation Mass Spectroscopy. And he's hooded by Dr. Glenn Jackson. Now I present you Dr. Simulacin Nicomo. His thesis title is Synchronizing Behavior in Coupled Chemical Oscillators, hosted by Professor Ken Showalter. Now I present you Dr. Sirpad Lohar Tagahong, and hooded by Professor Showalter. His thesis title, Hydrogen Deuterium Exchange Study by Mass Spectrometry, a method for obtaining conformational studies of protein in solution. Now I present you Dr. Qiaoyi Wang. His thesis title, 1-2-3 triazo as a special X factor in gold activation of challenging CC triple bond activation, hooded by me. Now I present you Dr. Wei Zhang. He's going to be hooded by Dr. Harry Finkley. His thesis title, Gas Phase Analysis of the Anode Exod of a Solid Oxide Fuel Cell. Now I'm presenting you Mr. Yumeng He. He's received the Master of Science thesis title Develop of a CC and six bond formation reaction through Gold-Lewis catalysis, and hooded by me. Thank you very much.
Good morning. I am Matt Martin, Chair of the Department of Communication Studies, and it is my pleasure to introduce candidates for the PhD in Communication Studies. Dr. Zach D. Johnson, Doctor of Philosophy. His dissertation is Alternative Breaks, the Impact of Student-to-Student Connections and Non-Classroom Service Learning Experiences, and he's being hooded by myself. Dr. Sarah Beth LaBelle. The title of her dissertation is Addressing the Role of Health Literacy in Social Science, the Revision and Validation of the Perceived Oral Health Literacy Scale, and she is being hooded by her advisor, Dr. Keith Weber. Dr. Jocelyn Eileen Vallade. The title of her dissertation is Extradiadic Communication with Friends About Negative Relational Events in Romantic Relationships, Development of a Measure and Implications for Friendship and Romantic Relationship Functioning. And she is being hooded by her advisor, Dr. Megan R. Dillo. Dr. Lori Elizabeth Bella. The title of her dissertation is Investigating the Effect of Humor Communication Skills Training on Pro-Social and Antisocial Humor Styles, Cognitive Learning, Self-Efficacy, Motivation, and Humor Use, and I will be hooding her. We now have several individuals receiving their master's degree, and they will be hooded by Dr. Keith Weber. Elzbieta Dominica Klein. Philippa Ann Lewin. Jessica Dawn Lynch. Tracy Lynn Mallow. Tess Marie Martin.
Good morning, I'm Jim Harms, Chair of the Department of English. It's my great pleasure to introduce our candidate for the PhD in English, Dr. Susan Jennings Lance, Doctor of Philosophy. The title of her dissertation is America's Lollipop Licking Teas, Images of Children in 1930s Film. She's being hooded by Dr. Laura Brady. We have several candidates for the Master of Arts degree in English. The first, and these will all be hooded, by the way, by Dr. Brian Ballantyne. The first is John Kirby. He's receiving a Master's of Arts in Professional Writing and Editing. Micah Conkling, Master of Arts in English. Crystal Harper, Master of Arts in English. Hillary Long, Master of Arts in English. And Harrington Weil, Master of Arts in English. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Keith Morris. I'm the Program Director of the Forensic and Investigative Science Program, and it is my pleasure to introduce the student who has completed the requirements for the Master's degree in Forensic and Investigative Science and will be hooded by myself. Michael Reed Fagot.
Good morning, I'm Steve Kite. I'm chair of the Department of Geology and Geography. I'd like to introduce a candidate for the Doctor of Philosophy in Geology, Stacy Jane Berry. The title of her dissertation, Using Active Learning Strategies to Investigate Student Learning and Attitudes About Geology in a Large Enrollment Class. Her Ph.D. advisor is going to hood her, Dr. Jack Renton, a WVU alum. I'm also pleased to introduce the candidate for the master's degree in geology, also being hooded by Dr. Jack Renton. This is Gary Wayne Daft, Jr.
Good morning. I am Elizabeth Phoneswolf, Chair of the Department of History, and it's my pleasure to introduce the candidate for Ph.D. in History, Dr. Kathleen Joan Fichtel. In her title of her dissertation is An Environmental History of Malawi's Island in the Sky, the Malanje Cedar and Scientific Forestry in British Nyasaland from 1890 to 1964, and she is being hooded by her advisor, Dr. Joseph Hodge. It is now my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the master's degree in history. The first one is Nick McGinnis, who is being hooded by his advisor, Dr. Joseph Hodge. Brendan Michael Muckian Bates, who is being hooded by his advisor, Dr. Kate Staples. Allison Marie Perry, who is being hooded by her advisor, Dr. Ken Thoneswolf. Zachary Christian Kalsert, who is being hooded by his advisor, Brian Lusky, Dr. Brian Lusky. Jessica May Mathias, hooded by Dr. Brian Lusky. Charles Richard Welsko III, again being hooded by Dr. Brian Lusky.
Good morning, I'm Eddie Fuller, Chair of the Department of Mathematics. It is my pleasure to introduce the students who have completed requirements for a master's degree in mathematics, being hooded by Dr. Mike Mays. Samuel John Hawkins. Neil Yelmert Jurgensen. Clark David Metz.
Good morning, I am David Litterman. I'm the chair of the Department of Physics and Astronomy. It is my pleasure to introduce candidates for the PhD in physics. First, we have Dr. Jerry Carr. The dissertation title is Laser-Induced Fluorescence Studies of Electrostatic Double Layers in an Expanding Helicon Plasma. He will be hooded by Dr. Earl Scime. Dr. Michael Allen Linden. The title of his dissertation is Carbon Dioxide Dissociation Using the Versatile Atmospheric Dielectric Barrier Discharge Experiment, VADER. He will be also hooded by Dr. Earl Scime. Next is Dr. Joshua James Miller, Multi-Wavelength Studies of Rotating Radio Transients. He will be hooded by Dr. Maura McLaughlin. Next is Dr. Andrew David Seymour. Title of the dissertation is A Study of Dynamical and Emission Variabilities in Pulsars. He will be hooded by Dr. Duncan Lorimer.
Good morning, I'm Jason McDonald, Associate Professor and Director of Graduate Studies in the Department of Political Science. It is my pleasure to introduce candidates for the Ph.D. in Political Science. Dr. Velda Frisco. American Grail, Contemporary Federal Budget Reform, hooded by Dr. Richard Brisbane. Dr. Sarah Michelle Motes. Venue Shopping, Domestic Interest in Global Politics, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Richard Brisbane. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Kevin Lark, and I'm the chair of the Department of Psychology. And it's my pleasure to introduce our candidates for the PhD in psychology. Dr. Carolyn Michelle Siliberte, title of her dissertation, Emotion Regulation and Threat Estimation as Mediators of the Relation Between Cognitive Functioning and Anxiety in Late Life, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Barry Edelstein. Next, we have Dr. Lindsay Angelin Corman, title of the dissertation, Factors Associated with Transition from Pediatric to Adult Healthcare in Cystic Fibrosis, hooded by her chair, Dr. Christina Duncan. Next, Tara Eileen Carnes, title of the dissertation, Using a Three-Dimensional Model to Understand Age Differences in the Framing Effect, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Janelle Strau. Dr. Philip Charles Lemaster, title of his dissertation, Gender and Financial Risk Tolerance Across the Lifespan, also hooded by Dr. Janelle Strau. Dr. Amanda Lee McBean, title of her dissertation, Effects of Postpartum Sleep Schedule on Childless Women's Sleep, Circadian Amplitude, Daytime Sleepiness, Performance, and Mood, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Holly Montgomery Down. Dr. Darcy Nicole Powell, title of her dissertation, Mother's Adaptation to Caring for a New Baby, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Catherine Character. Dr. Paula Rose Prentice, title of her dissertation, Stress and Obesity, Facilitation of Neuroendocrine and Autonomic Nervous System Recovery from Stress While Eating Comfort Foods, hooded by her advisor, Dr. Kevin Larkin. It's now my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the master's degree in psychology. They will be hooded by Dr. Karen Anderson, Associate Professor, Associate Chair in the Department of Psychology. Megan Elizabeth Follett. Margot Marissa Gray. Holly Christian Hunsberger. Meredith Ann Norman. Christina Lee Patton. Carolyn Catherine Rudy.
Good morning, my name is Maya Holmes, representing the Department of Public Administration, and it's my distinct pleasure to introduce the candidates, the folks who have earned the Master of Public Administration, and they will be hooded by Dr. Margaret Stout. Erica Algio. Brian Batten. Brittany Campanella. Kylie Edmond. Elena Garten. Jordan Glass. LJ Gravel. Christina Harris. Alice Hudson. Whitney Kynes. Taylor McCulloch. Catherine Moran. Helen Nadici. Scott Olivo. Eric Powell. Destiny Riggleman. Amy Rohr. Caroline Smith. Beverly Steele. Elizabeth Stone. It is my distinct pleasure to also introduce the individual who has completed the requirements for the Master of Legal Studies, Issam Koshak.
Good morning. For those of you following in the program, we're at the S's, so we're really close. Also, if you are following, not all of the people listed under social work are choosing to participate in today's ceremony, so hang tight. My name is Helen Hartnett. I'm the director of the graduate program in the School of Social Work, and it is my honor this morning to present to you the candidates who have completed their degree requirements for the Master's in Social Work. They are being hooded by Neil Newfield, Karen Harper-Dorton, Haejeong Kim, Carrie Rischel, Jackie Englehart, and Christina Hash. Medina Bent Ali. And Talise Latrice Bonner. Brandy Lynn Davis. Rachel Lydia Dunn. Lindsay Marie Fitzpatrick. Christopher Allen Friend. Christina Janae Bryson. Catherine Lynn Harmon. Sarah Michelle Houghton. Kristen Elise Kelly. Veronica Brene Kimple. Quinn L. Crotteville. Kelsey Lynn Lewis. Sheila Loco. Kelly Teresa McDonald. Catherine Janice McPherson. Taylor Leanne McKellick. Corey Joe Phillips. Sierra Sherelle Ramsey. Jennifer Dale Seal.
No, I deserve a high five for that, buddy.
Robert Mark Shockley. Jeremy Allen Spear. Jessica Lynn Staley. Andrew Nicholas Summers. Ashley Kyle Alice Talbot. Miranda Beth Talkington. Casey Jean Knight Tennant. Melissa Shirley Trott.
And Dana, I got it.
Mandana Ruth Wyrick. Philip James West. Maria Wolf. And last, but certainly not least, Megan Lee Young.
Good morning. I am Corey Collier, Chair of the Department of Sociology and Anthropology. It is my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the master's degree in sociology, being hooded by Dr. Joshua Woods. Brent Alfred Boyd. Lindsay Grace Doty. Barbara Frances Prince. Angela Justine Sikafoos.
Good morning. I am Jim Horner. I'm chair of the Department of Statistics. It is my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the Master of Science in Statistics. These students will be hooded by Dr. Phil Turk. Ahmed Alawami. Thank you. Frey Nayef Alenze. Chuchen Lee. Dr. Turk was her advisor. Daniel James Pyatt. It is now my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the Master of Professional Studies in Applied Statistics, Dr. Mike Mays Will Hood, Noura Mohammed Alsassi, Bashira Sabib Al-Zalbi. Shri Vishnu Prasad Malapati. Rebecca Dawn Tawabrawa. In addition to getting the Master of Public Professional Studies, she served many years for the Department of Statistics.
Good morning. I'm Angel Tuninetti, Chair of the Department of World Languages, Literatures, and Linguistics. It is my pleasure to introduce students who have completed the requirements for the master's degree in World Languages, Literatures, and Linguistics, being headed by Dr. Sandra Stepanovic, Dr. Lisa Di Bartolomeo, and Dr. Pablo Garcia. From Saudi Arabia, Moaz Abbasayed. From Spain, Laura Aguilar García. From Saudi Arabia, Mohammed Al-Samani. From Colombia, Ángela Bejarano Barrera. From Spain, Sara Cayón Alonso. From Nepal, Tanka Dahal. from West Virginia, Josh Doherty. From Spain, Marina Escamés Ballesta. From New York, Caitlin Flattery. From Ukraine, Katerina Forina. From Italy, Clarissa Frigerio. From Spain, Lorena Gastelumendi López. From Italy, Veronica Getti. From Argentina, Ana Laura Gil. From France, Tito Javinguali. From Spain, Cristina Lumera López. From Russia, Tatiana Maslova. From Spain, Maria Olivera Álvarez. From West Virginia, Faith Pirlo. From Maryland, Corey Pono. From West Virginia, Brittany Radcliffe. From Colombia, Falcon Restrepo Ramos. From North Carolina, Christine Richmond. From West Virginia, Rurik Tiwanib. And from Serbia, Budinka Muskoković Tenin. Thank you very much.
How about that? Pretty good, huh? Please welcome Provost Wheatley to the podium for the conferral of degrees.
Well, I don't know if you're ready, but I'm ready. This is fifth ceremony out of six. Will the degree candidates from the Eberly College of Arts and Sciences please rise? As students in West Virginia University's largest and most diverse college, you represent a wide range of disciplines. Your clarity of thought, flair for communication, ability to discover new information, and passion for learning will be sought after in your chosen field. Among you are future scientists, researchers, authors, and educators. Your studies in literature, the humanities, mathematics, the natural sciences, and the social and behavioral sciences have prepared you to thrive as a professional and become a leader in your community. As a West Virginia University graduate, aspire to put your education to work to solve the world's greatest challenges. Hone your ability to uncover facts, analyze problems, and share knowledge. Dream big and take your mountaineer pride wherever you go. You are the best ambassadors for WVU and the power of education. And now, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the West Virginia University Board of Governors, I hereby confer upon you the degrees for which you have been recommended with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto. Please join me in congratulating our newest graduates.
Okay, we have one important thing to do now. I invite Dr. Michael Slavin, a graduate of the Department of History, to provide the alumni charge to our graduates. Dr. Slavin holds three WVU degrees and is currently a scholar of French history with a faculty appointment at California University of Pennsylvania. Mike is a loyal mountaineer who has helped the Eberly College and WVU in many ways, including his service as member of the Eberly College Alumni Advisory Board. Dr. Slavin.
Good morning, everybody. On behalf of the WVU Alumni Association and all of those graduates of West Virginia University who have preceded you, I extend to each member of the class of 2014 congratulations and best wishes. Today, you're joining a legacy of success that reaches back almost 150 years. Each WVU graduate has a unique story. Now it's time to write yours. With that in mind, class of 2014, from WVU graduates everywhere, this is our charge to you. Work hard to develop your unique gifts. Take risks and don't fear making mistakes. Be flexible. Cultivate a global perspective and work towards creating a more peaceful and just world. Think of yourself and always choose to be an innovator. explore new perspectives and places, and as you travel the world, wear your flying WV with pride. Honor the sacrifices of those who came before you and extend a helping hand to those who follow. Above all, never stop learning. And when people ask you the secret of your success, tell them you're a mountaineer. Thank you and congratulations.
Class of 2014, family and friends, faculty and honored guests, please rise as we join together in singing the words of our alma mater, written in 1938 by WVU graduate student Lewis Corson. During the singing of the alma mater, it is customary for gentlemen to remove their caps. You'll find the words of the alma mater on the inside cover of the program. At the conclusion of the alma mater, we will have an orderly recessional, and I ask all of you in the audience to remain in your chairs until the platform party and the students have finished their recessional. And I invite you to join us for a reception in the lobby of the Creative Arts Center.
Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye, country road, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country.
haven't moved